Hey guys, hello there. So today's theme is bird illustration with the letter E, and I have been doing this series of bird illustration, and I really like drawing animals in general. If you are new to my channel, I wanted to mention that I really like drawing animals. Personally, I feel like if you are not able to contribute to the environment and the animal conservation, you can obviously speak about that and at least come to know about the beautiful birds we have in nature. If you're not a bird lover like me, I don't think you would like knowing about facts, but personally, I feel like just drawing a particular bird which looks beautiful is not something I like. I like knowing about that bird and then drawing about then drawing that portrait of a bird. And the bird which I'm drawing with the letter E is a European goldfinch. And European goldfinch are very easily found in the Himalayan region or in India. And when you go outside India, you'll see these birds more often in Europe, north of Africa, and Western Asia. And even in some parts of New Zealand, Uruguay, and Australia, and they actually come under the least concerned species under the IUCN. IUCN is an organization which grades every organism and grades them that how much conservation they need, and they are merely like 14 centimeter long. They are very beautiful birds, and I remember seeing one of these while I was traveling. I think to Manali, that's place in India. Manali is actually a place in India, and I didn't know the name of the bird, that it was actually European goldfinch. And when I was searching for some birds according to the series which I'm doing. So I just came across this bird luckily, and I was really happy to see that I was able to track down the bird which I actually saw when I was traveling to the place called Manali. And they most often feed on, I would say, small seeds, tree seeds. During winters, these goldfinches often travel in groups or flocks of 40, and goldfinches are attracted to back gardens in Europe and North America by bird seeders. And so you can see overall these birds are really pretty looking, and I would just say something about their appearance. The goldfinches has a really red face and black and white head. The black wings have a chestnut brown color. So this chestnut brown color was the thing I really wanted to color out this in this watercolor illustration. So what I did, I took a burnt cyan color, and I used just a light shade of that to give it a bit of chestnut color. You can even mix the white color with the chestnut brown. And I wanted to show this time I wanted to show which all colors I'm using for from the palette. The palette I'm using here is a Camlin watercolor artist palette. It's a pan one. You can also get the tube one, but I feel like there are differences in the pan and the tubes. There are some shades that are different from pan and the tubes. As you can see, the bird, I've left the areas where there's white. I often fill up the areas that are lighter at the end, especially the white one. I take care of the fact that I would color it at the end, because white needs quite a little bit of shading. That's how I prefer. I've seen many artists suggest that you should go from a lighter shade to a darker shade. And I know that the lines of the pencils are not visible because I like sketching out the outline of the bird before going in with colors. And initially, you might have seen me rubbing off this blank page. I was actually rubbing off the graphite to prevent it from mixing in with the watercolor which I'm using. So that was the purpose of rubbing off the sheet. And then the color which I'm taking here is a bit of orange and burnt sienna color into a washed out color, and I'm just roughly giving it a brushed out stroke. I like doing that in bird to give it a nice feel of feathers. And you can do that too. There's another tip I would like to give you. If you want a feathery effect to a bird, first go in with a beige shade, a very light beige shade, and then go in with the darker shade. After that whole base shade dries out, go in with the darker shade of the same color that the feather is, and just strike, give little minute strokes like the way I'm doing here. You can see there. Initially, I've placed a washed out shade of burnt sienna color from the palette, and then I'm taking a bit concentrated shade of burnt sienna. I've not used much water. And then I'm going in with that shade. Recently, I have been liking the way I've been using the colors, acrylic colors along with the watercolors. So the way I use it is very simple, and I'll explain to you later when I actually use acrylics. So, and if you guys want to know much detailed things about any piece, do let me know in the suggestion box below. I'll definitely put that on my Patreon page. I have a Patreon page. If you guys would like to follow me there, you can definitely do that. I do have some polls there, and I have recently updated my Patreon page, and I want to pay more attention to that page. If you guys want me to tell you some tips and secret tips which I follow on YouTube, you can definitely follow me there. You'll get the answers you want. And so moving on with the illustration which I am doing here is I'm taking a light shade of this yellow along with initially I've laid down a sap green color. This is actually acrylic. I often use acrylic not directly from the bottle but from the cap of the bottle. And the brand which I'm using over here is Fevicryl Pedialyte Acrylic. Those fabric paints you get, these are easily available for I think 20 rupees. They're very cheap and affordable, and people think that affordable, the cheaper art stuff, are not good for your painting, but I don't think so because I've used this acrylic and I find it very nice and smooth. They are not very thick and they are not even very thin. They are somewhere in between. And they give a really nice glossy finish, which I really like about acrylic. And you get this in if you buy these acrylics in bulk, I think you'll get a discount from the local store. I quickly wanted to mention, if you are buying art supplies online, I would recommend you to buy in bulk or don't buy it from online because I've seen the differences in the price. They charge a bit 50, I think 100 rupees more because they have to register online and they will definitely want to make profit, so they add on the shipping or some other hidden price in the acrylics they give. And I think I bought these acrylic, I think 5 to 6 acrylics together, and it costed me around 18 rupees per bottle instead of 20. I actually got a discount from my local store because of buying it offline. And I feel like the local store which I have here has a really nice collection of acrylics. I will show it to you, or I will be uploading it, that whole collection of my acrylics. I'll put the link in the description box below. I've done a video on that, and I've really been liking the combination of acrylics and watercolor together somehow. And yeah, I would suggest you to do so, and see for yourself. And I've been really liking the use of opaque colors along with watercolors, because there are times when I like having a lighter wash of colors over my paintings, and there are places where I like darker and opaque shades in my painting. And you can see there, wherever I wanted a darker shade of yellow, I've painted it in acrylic. The yellow patches you can see in the branches, those are made out of acrylics. And initially I don't think the white color of the acrylic was visible, but I've actually painted the white part of the flower in acrylic. And it might not be visible on camera, or maybe it will be visible as a off-white color, but I really wanted to add some flowers here and there. And overall, this goldfinch is exactly how I wanted it to turn out, and I was really happy with this whole piece. So yeah, this is my finished piece. I hope you guys like this. And I do have Instagram page if you want to follow me there. I post my pictures, all the bird illustrations there. If you want to follow me there, you'll get to see a closer look of my pictures, like the sketches, even the sketches which I don't do on birds. I've done some sketches, really nice ones. You can see there, and you can judge it for yourself. So yeah, I hope you guys like this, and this tutorial, or I would say this bird series, was helpful for you. And yeah, thanks for watching, and do support me by buying art stuff. I have a store of mine on TeePublic and Society 6, and you can get the art prints. If you want this art print, do let me know. Yeah, and thanks for watching.